actually did my graduation from BSc IT. I was always into drawing and stuff. But during 2008, I came across an anime called Naruto. And now I've always been a fan of He-Man, Thundercats and 80s shows. But then in 2007, when I came across Naruto, I completely got, you know, got inspiration from it to pursue animation, because that's a style I really, really like. And it happened to be anime style. I had a concept in mind at that time. Graduation period, I created a small script, which then I further developed. And finally, I made this comic called The Beast Legion. And when I had to do it, I said I had to do it in manga style, because initially it was tough. Initially it was tough to get the style right, so it shows in the first two issues. But after that, once I got the hang of it, I think that's become my signature style now, and which I'll be showcasing today in this particular live sketch session. Mangas are basically a form of Japanese drawings. Now it's become more of a genre in comics, and they basically focus on long short stories which almost cover every facet of human behavior, from action, adventure, emotion, everything. And the best part is it touches you. It touches you at a certain core level, and that's pretty much what inspired me to go with that approach for this series, because I actually have a 52 episode series planned out for Beast Legion. Hopefully in the future I would like to see it turn into an anime, but at present it's still a comic, and I think of it as a storyboard for a upcoming series or something like that. So I'll start with the process of creating the page. So basically the tools that I use for my drawing are basically my PC and my trusted Wacom Intuos 5. I am a complete digital artist. I don't use a pencil or a paper. I haven't been using it for the last 5 years now. And I completely do my work digitally on this tablet. So to start off, first what I do is I create random thumbnails based on what I have in mind, or sometimes the script. Currently the pages I'm doing is something that's a scene that's already in my mind, and I'm just going to put it out on paper. I mean on canvas right now on the PC. So here goes. So first I just rough out the basic thumbnails for the particular episode. And this is a scene where this wizard is in a battle with the main bad guy of the series, so it's going to be a little action-packed page. Thumbnails are basically rough sketches that I create before I plan out the entire page. Basically, thumbnails are like small panels that before creating the main panel, I rough them out. And once that's done, I actually focus on the final liner. This is just a very rough way of, you know, putting images into place and then creating the page. So there are still a few to go right now. I'll just continue the process. That's what I forgot to say. Manga is generally black and white comics. There are certain color splash pages in the beginning of the chapters, but generally manga is always black and white, and it of course reads from right to left instead of left to right as traditional comics. However, with my comic, I do keep the left to right scenario, which is always there because it's a web comic, and Indians are not used to reading it in that particular fashion. So that's how I have to keep it that way. So I first thumbnail the characters, and once that's done, I actually plan the layout for the boxes. I don't plan the box layout before I work on the page, because I get a lot of freedom this way, exactly what to cut off, and some people find it comfortable and panels are laid out. Mine is exactly the opposite. Basically, this is what is called a thumbnailing, and I basically have a rough layout set for the final panel layout, and even now I won't add the boxes around the characters, that will be added at the very end. So next is we'll go with the final line art for this particular page, and I'm going to start with that right now. So this is what this thumbnailing is all about. This particular file I created before the recording took place. I'll be working on that because it's kind of closer to what I had in mind for the page. And so thumbnailing remains the same. We won't be adding the panels right now. I add the panels usually at the end of the whole process. So right now the next phase we'll be going to is finalizing the line art. So I'm going to start right now. So what I do first is I reduce the transparency of this layer. If you can see, I'll reduce the transparency to around 40-30% or so. I create a new layer just below that particular file and just fill it with white so that I get a clear idea of what I have to draw. And now I'll be filling in the whole, creating the whole line art from scratch. So now that the thumbnailing is done, I have a clear idea of exactly what I have to draw. So here goes the final line art. Before I go ahead with this, I'll just explain what's happening in the pages. I forgot to explain that. So basically these two wizards are having a fight. This wizard is almost down and his name is Master Groto. This guy is the main bad guy called Drago. So they are both having a fight. This guy, the Master Groto, is a little worn out, and Drago prepares to land the finishing blow. But just before that, Master Groto comes behind him and, you know, kind of slashes his neck apart. So that's the particular scene in this page. You'll get a clear idea once the final lines are in. Basically what I'm doing is I'm on panel number 3 right now, where Dracos is pulling off his main weapon before finishing off the old wizard. And what I'm doing, there's no real rocket science, it's just plain, I'm just drawing as I go. There's no technique or anything involved in this, I'm just very familiar with the characters. Basically Beast Legion, what Beast Legion is, it's all about the tale of this guy who transforms into a particular beast form, but he and his beast form don't really meet eye to eye. They are not exactly on the same page. So the story focuses on how he tries to tame his beast form while he takes on the forces of evil and how he comes to terms with it. The reason I do thumbnailing is because it makes, you know, later the final lines become easy if a character is in a particular perspective. Like in the third panel, the camera is from a top view, while in the second panel, it's from below the character and it's pointing upwards. When you thumbnail, it gives you a clear idea, so your line art doesn't go wrong when you go into the final phase. And generally, all the pages in the comic are very perspective driven, so I have to be really careful, you know, if that I thumbnail it right. We'll be right back. I'm going to explain a little about Beast Legion. Beast Legion has been an online project that is my passion. I have a proper story layout set for it. And the story focuses on this prince called Zeus, who is trying to reclaim his homeland, which has fallen under the power of an evil warlock named Dragos. He's an extremely powerful character. And the thing is, every character in this series has a particular beast form. For Dragos, it's a blue sapphire dragon. For Zeus, it's a white tiger. So it kind of goes with the Chinese zodiac contrast between the tiger and the dragon. That's how the concept had come into mind for the final characters. Now, the thing is, with Beast Legion, it's the story about how Zeus comes to terms with his beast form. His beast form is extremely aggressive and actually doesn't like Zeus. But over the course of the journey, they bond with each other and they make new friends, new allies, and they take on a plethora of evil villains. And it's also how the story progresses from one phase to another, and how the relationship between Zeus and his beast comes into the picture and broadens the whole series on a different level. So right now what I'm doing is the second step, which is the final line art. After that is done, I create panels, and that is something I will be explaining in this next step. So yeah, I just have to make sure everything falls under these panels. So now that everything is set, it becomes extremely easy. I just have to put the lines according to the character designs. Now, paneling is something that depends on you. You can change it as per your convenience. Sometimes certain panels may overlap other panels. Like the cape, I'm not really cutting the whole screen here, but I'm actually letting the cape overlay on the panel just below it. Even in this last panel, the wizard's staff actually overlays above the panel on top of it. So it gives that whole 3D sort of effect, which adds a lot to the comic in the long run. So this about completes the final line art for the page. The next step we'll be moving on to will be shading the characters. And I generally do it in two layers. One layer I create below the file, and it's set to an opacity of 37% or 30 to 37% depending on how I want to shade the characters. So first we do the shading, and then we do the actual skin tones and the text, the color of the characters. I watch a lot of anime, so this kind of the shading part comes naturally. For those of you who are planning to go into comics, especially manga style comics, I recommend you check out all the different manga books. Every book has a different style of shading and stuff like that. But if you check out anime, you'll get a perfect sense of shading once you know you watch an episode 3 to 4 times just to observe that. You'll get a very clear idea of how shading is handled in anime and manga. Now we are moving on to the second panel, and the second panel has Dragos' face, so he really needs to look sinister. So what I plan is the light comes from down and it reflects, the shadows reflect on the face and especially the eyes. So it gives them a more menacing feel.
The concept of anime in India is really not foreign. Anime came into India the time AXN started. AXN was the one that, you know, aired all the shows like Ninku, Yamato Takeru, Ghost Sweeper, which actually caught a lot of people's attention at that time. However, in this last 3 years, you know, after Animax started and Cartoon Network at the same time was airing Naruto, that's when the craze kind of caught up a little. Not much, but at least a little. And now in the last 3 years, the way I've seen anime fans and, you know, manga fans evolve in India is amazing. Look at Comic Con. There's a study that at least 60% of the cosplayers at Comic Con cosplay anime characters. Get my point? And now we are even getting, thanks to, you know, Comic Con and Flipkart, mangas are actually available online and at a pretty decent price. So it's definitely growing. The market is there. It's just that it's very untapped at the moment. At present, channels should take note of that and, you know, get content that is a little more action-packed as well as has this emo quotient which all anime and manga series have. I think if we tap that, and even if one series breaks through, it'll be a big turn in Indian animation.
So basically, this last panel, in, as you can see, involves a lot of shadowing. The reason is, here there is no particular light source as such that I have in mind, but it's more on the character's expression. Like, there is a fear that needs to be shown on the main villain's face because he doesn't even know that he's been cut. And the wizard doesn't have to be that much in focus, so I've generally put a more darker light on him, so that only parts of his outline are a little more visible than the other parts of this character. So the thing is, here the focus has to be is actually on Dragos's face, so his fear needs to show. That's why the shadow lines come across the face, and it in anime that shows a sense of urgency. And as I said, as for the wizard, he's not the main topic in this whole scene, so I've decided to shadow him at least 80%, and that's about it for this particular scene. I have to give the final colors for the character, the final shading for the character. So what I do is I create a new layer below the shadow layer, and that is set to 100% opacity. What I do here is I take the paint bucket and then I reduce the opacity of the paint bucket to fill in the colors for this particular scene. So as I go ahead, you'll get to know how it's done. What I'm doing here is, I'm actually selecting areas that come in the same shade of gray. So, once I do this, I'll fill in the entire area. Again, what I'm doing here is, I'm selecting specific regions that fall under the same shade of gray. So, the process moves faster that way. I adjust the paint bucket levels. Then I go to select, modify, expand. So what this does is, it reduces the line gap between the lines and the color tones. So this is how your basic finished panel looks like. As you can see, as I said again, the whole focus is on Dragos' expression. That is the highlight of the whole panel. That's how I generally work. My comic is fully grey shaded, there's no color in it. So I already have these ready-made balloon files that I use for the series. And these are basically regular balloons, circles. And these are known as broadcast balloons. Like, if there's a sense of urgency in a character or if he shouts, we use these type of balloons. And in normal circumstances, we use the regular circle balloons with the tails. For this particular scene, we'll be using two of them. So what we are using here is a broadcast balloon. Dragos really doesn't know what's hit him already. He's in a state of panic of sorts. That's why we use a broadcast balloon, and he's surprised. So he's just saying, huh? So the broadcast balloons are usually used to detect shock, you know, excitement or motions like that. And speech bubbles are used when characters are calm or, you know, talking on a casual way or something like that. So the wizard is extremely calm in this scene. So I use a regular font called Anime Ace. I mean, for Anime Ace or Digital Strip. There are two fonts that I use on a regular basis. So lettering goes on in different layers basically. As I keep putting each voice bubble, another layer comes up. So lettering takes most of the layers in this particular comic, in any comic for that matter. To just thank Animation Express for giving me this opportunity. You guys can check out all the latest updates on animation in the world of animation, VFX, comics on animationexpress.com.